food safety officer questions. So the first question is, consumption of raw soya bean can be harmful to health because of the presence of following anti-nutritional factors. So the trypsin inhibitor present in soya bean is harmful to health, and that's why consumption of trypsin inhibitor is not good. So this trypsin inhibitor is removed by the help of de-oiling from soya bean. So trypsin inhibitor is the anti-nutritional factor. Anti-nutritional factors are those factors which work against the health. It means they have some adverse health effect. Next question. In a standard fruit jam preparation, the content of total soluble solids not be less than 65% W by W. So this total soluble solids, this TSS, are what? Like salt, sugar, or any other solids that can be added into that jam preparation, which will be mixed within the jam preparation, is 65% W by W. You cannot add more than this percentage as per FSSAI regulations. Next question. The safe level of irradiations for food which presents no toxicological hazards is how much? It is 10 kilogram. So this irradiation of foods is also called what? Cold sterilizations, and this is mainly done to kill harmful pathogens. And inhibition of sprouting or germination, we do irradiations. And irradiation is compulsory for mango if you are exporting to America. Then this irradiation symbol means there is a necessity to put one radura mark if that food product is irradiated. So the 10 kilogram is having no toxicological hazards. Above it, there is some toxicological hazards. Then subjecting rice to higher degree of polishing is associated with following. See, whenever we process the raw rice, we polish that raw rice. So what happens after that? It lowers the nutritional values and improves the cooking characteristics. The quality, the nutritional value will be reduced, but the appearance, the taste may be improved. But the polishing leads to lowering of nutrition value. Then the browning occurring in cut apples on aeration is due to the presence of what? It is due to the presence of polyphenolases. So whenever one apple is cut, then this apple is exposed to the oxygen, and that's why the reaction leads to some browning on that cut part. That's why this polyphenolases are the enzymes which is present inside the apple, and they make that apple brownish in color. Next question. FSSAI stands for Food Safety and Standard Authority of India. Next question. Identify the correct group of stimulating constituents present in India, in tea. So, these stimulating constituents are nothing but caffeine, theobromine and theophylline. These are stimulating constituents. After eating, taking tea, you will be stimulated, your mind will be stimulated due to this caffeine, theobromine and theophylline. Then acceptable daily intake level of additives is derived from following. So ADI, what is that? ADI is nothing but the total amount of additives you can take which will not harm your body. So this is determined by a group of people, by different studies on animal behaviors, human behaviors, and they found some level. That level does not cause any adverse health effects. So no observed adverse effect level of compound is determined. That is also called NOEL. And also there is uncertainty factors. These two are considered to determine ADI level of different kinds of preservatives, different kinds of additives. Okay, identify the cluster of essential fatty acids for humans from the following. So this linoleic and arachidonic acids are the essential fatty acids for humans. Okay, so right answer is B. Then aseptic packaging refers to what? It is the packaging technology used to store hygienically prepared food in a hygienic containers. So the right answer is packaging sterile food in sterile atmosphere in sterile packaging. So this is aseptic packaging. Both atmosphere and the packaging materials are sterile, then only we can call is aseptic packaging. Next question, the latest indicator organism for proper pasteurization is C. burnetii, Coxiella burnetii. This is one heat resistant bacteria, and it is used as an indicator organism. If this bacteria is killed, then we will be assured that all other bacteria, all other pathogenic bacteria, not vegetative or spore former, are killed. So next questions, Rasagulla is prepared using what? So by using chhena, we can prepare Rasagulla. Next, aseptic packaging is used after which among the following processing methods? So we can use aseptic packaging after doing pasteurizations. Then the water percentage of cow milk is approximately what? It is about 87%, not adulterated milk. It is the normal natural milk contains 87%. Okay, then which among the following practice reduces the occurrence of mastitis? So it is a disease due to which the mastitis happens, and it can be prevented by the help of teat dipping. Disinfections of the teat can be done to prevent which disease? Mastitis in cows. Then which among the following is used to test fat in milk? So we can use milkotester. Next, the bacterial culture used to prepare yogurt contains Streptococcus thermophilus and which organisms? It is Lactobacillus bulgarius. We can use two species for preparation of dahi or yogurt. that is Streptococcus thermophilus and Lactobacillus bulgarius as a starter culture to prepare dahi or yogurt. Then which among the following used to sterilize milk cans in dairies? So sterilization of the can is important to extend the shelf life. So we use steam sterilizations for milk cans in dairy industries. The base material for preparation of Shrikhand is what? It is curd. Then outlines diary of technology is written by Sukumar De. It is a book for dairy technology and it was written by Sukumar De. Then the pink color characteristic of cured milk, cured meat is due to the nitrosyl hemochromogen, The natural casing for sauces preparation is derived from intestinal submucosa, is used for sauces preparation. Then PSE condition of pork is caused due to short term pre-slaughter stress and repeat decline of muscle PS. So this condition is one adverse condition in meat of pork and it is due to the repeat decline of the PS and the stress the organism feel before it is going for slaughtering. So this is the right answer. A and C are right answer. Then vitamin, which vitamin is absent in eggs? So vitamin C is naturally absent in what? Chicken eggs. The bacterium known as terror of the deep due to the seafood poisoning is caused by Vibrio vulnificus. Vibrio vulnificus is the organism which is also called as terror of deep. Next, the stunning method recommended for slaughter of adult cattle is electronic stunning, penetrative captive bolt pistol, carbon dioxide gas stunning. All of the above is correct. So before slaughtering one animal, that animal should go through one stunning step or one senseless step so as that animal will not feel the pain. So all these methods, electronic, carbon dioxide gas stunning, penetrative captive bolt pistol, all of the above are used. Then the dressing percentage for pigs is approximately 75%. So what is this dressing percentage? The total percentage out of that animal which can not be used is called dressing percentage. Okay. Next question. Dex is used for testing the effectiveness of bleeding of carcass. So malachite green is used for testing the effectiveness of bleeding of carcasses. Why this test? Because all the blood should go out from that carcass. So in order to test whether all the blood is removed or not, you can use one chemical that is called malachite green. Then the larval nematode worm seen in striated muscles of pig infecting human beings after ingestion of such infected pork is Trichinella spiralis. It is a worm, okay, which is found in striated muscles of pigs. So we can say it is one worm, nematodes. Okay, Then pick out the wrong statement. The first transgenic cow, Rosie, produced human protein enriched milk, correct? The green rot in egg is mainly caused of Pseudomonas fluorescens, correct? Then bloom is the term used for preservation of meat using salt. No, this is wrong. That is called curing. Then pork and poultry meat are more susceptible to rancidity as they are richer in unsaturated fatty acids than other meats, correct? This is, so right answer is bloom is the term used for preservation of meat using salt. So this statement is wrong, which is the correct answer. Then in a complaint, no, we will not discuss those questions. We will only discuss those questions which are related to food science, food safety officer. Then unlicensed sale of food shall be punishable with what? It is imprisonment up to 6 months and fine up to 5 lakhs. So if you are selling one product which is not licensed and that food manufacturer is not licensed within the food authority, then you have to go for 6 months of jail and 5 lakhs of penalty after proper jurisdictions. Then death cost due to consumption of any food purchased from a seller is liable to be compensated with not less than 10 lakhs. If your product, if your food product has caused one harm and that harm leads to death, then you are penalized not less than 10 lakhs. You have to pay 10 lakhs after proper adjudications. Then the maximum penalty to be imposed on a person who sells any food which is not in compliance with the provisions or regulations of Food Safety Act is not exceeding 2 lakhs. If you are selling a food which is not complying the standard given by food authority, then you are liable to give the penalty not exceeding rupees 2 lakhs rupees. Then energy yield per unit weight of food is known as calorific value. Then RQ of fats is less than carbohydrates because fats have lesser oxygen content. This RQ is what? It is respiratory quotient, and fats have lesser oxygen content. That's why its RQ value is low than carbohydrate. So lesser oxygen leads to what? Less oxidations, or it will be oxidized in less amount. So those food molecules which are less oxidized will have less RQ value, and carbohydrate is having higher oxygen level. That's why it will be oxidized in more amount, and it's that's why its RQ value is how much? 1. Carbohydrate is having, glucose is having RQ value of 1. So the right answer is fats have lesser oxygen content, that's why its RQ value is less than carbohydrates. So that's why fats are recommended for asthmatic patients, because it produces less carbon dioxide as compared to carbohydrates food molecules. Then specific dynamic actions is referred to increased heat production following intake of food. When you take food, there is production of heat to compensate the digestions is also called specific dynamic actions, and these specific dynamic actions is mainly caused due to the fats, adipose tissue deposited in the body. The next question, DEX is essential amino acids. So 309 is the essential amino acids, as our body could not synthesize this particular amino acids. Then which of the following has the lowest iodine number? This beef fat is having lowest iodine number because it has low unsaturation level. Unsaturation level means what? It has less carbon-carbon double bond. If a fat is having more carbon-carbon double bond, then its iodine value is more because of that iodine absorption capacity is high. If unsaturation, if carbon-carbon double bond is carbon-carbon double bond is more, then the iodine number, iodine value will be more. The beef fat is having low level of iodine value, iodine number, because it has less carbon-carbon double bond. So, right answer is beef fat. Then scurvy can be cured by the administration of ascorbic acid. So, scurvy is a disease due to the scarcity of vitamin C in our body, and it leads to bleeding of gum, weakness of teeth, and it can be cured by the help of what? Ascorbic acid consumptions. Then dietary fibers refers to the following nutrient groups. It is a carbohydrate group which is not digestible by the help of enzymes produced by human, and that's why they are called dietary fibers. It helps in proper formation of stools or proper removal of stools. Then the one which is not used as clarifier, that is phosphotungistic acid. So what is the use of clarifier? Clarifier mainly removes the suspended solid particles from the juice preparations, but phosphotungistic acid could not be used as clarifier. Then ionization technique not used in mass spectrometry is radiation. What we do in ionization technique? We make the sample ionized to be read by mass spectrophotometer detector, but radiation is not used to ionize the sample. We use fast atom bombardment technology, field desorption technology, laser desorption technology to ionize the sample, but we don't use radiations because we don't want to make the sample radioactive. Okay, different reasons is there. Then inhomogeneity of flow velocity and path length around peaking particles in column chromatography leads to what? Eddy diffusion. So whenever we use one column for chromatography purpose, what happens? The solid particles, different solid particles will take different path, different velocity. So this leads to what? This leads to what? Eddy diffusion. So it is called what? Eddy diffusion. And in homogeneity of flow velocity, this flow velocity of particles and path length is also not homogeneous, and that's why the diffusion is happened, and that diffusion is called eddy diffusions. So with this we have understood some important questions from Food Safety Officer Kerala. Okay, so thank you.